My name is Ashutosh Rastogi. I'm a teacher by profession. My mission is to impart quality education for all. For that purpose, I am creating these videos. If you appreciate my work, then please do like my video and subscribe my channel so that I could get the motivation to prepare more videos.
Anyways, in this particular lecture, we're going to discuss about preemphasis and deemphasis in the frequency modulated systems. So these are the outlines. We'll start up with the introduction, where we're going to find out what is the need of using preemphasis and deemphasis at frequency modulated systems. Then we'll discuss about noise suppression effects of FM, how frequency modulated signals actually suppress out the effect of additive white Gaussian noise. Then we'll discuss about preemphasis and deemphasis in the frequency modulated systems. Finally, we'll discuss about some major applications of AM and FM in human life. So here is the introduction. We already know that noise usually have a higher amplitude at higher frequency components. Obviously, we are talking about high frequency noise. On close observation of high frequency noise, we have established that they will have higher impact at the higher frequency components in comparison to our lower frequency components. So these high frequency noise will lead to the frequency distortions when its amplitude is higher than the components present in the modulating signal. So obviously, if noise like signal's amplitude is much greater than our message signal amplitude, then the effect of noise will be more, as we'll going to have much more distorted signal. So to overcome this situation, most of the FM circuits use a particular technique which is known as preemphasis at the transmitter and deemphasis at the receiver. We are basically using two types of filter circuitry, one at the transmitter and one at the receiver. So before we'll discuss about what is preemphasis and deemphasis in the frequency modulated systems, let us quickly discuss about the noise suppression effect of frequency modulated signals. So this particular figure shows the frequency modulated waveform. As we could see that the frequencies of the carrier wave is keep on changing. Here they are compressed one and here they are expanded one. So due to the effect of noise, we'll be getting these noise like spikes which are shown in these black colors spike. So here these signals are being considered as noise spikes. Noise are actually occurring very shorter duration of time and with variable amplitude. So on close observation, we could find out that these spikes at particular instance or at particular interval of times, they will going to added up with our message signal. So likewise, at this position and at this position, due to the additive nature of noise, we'll going to get the distorted signal. So what we could actually do is, if we could use a circuitry which could clip it off these excess amount of amplitude value of my signal which has been produced due to the noise. So we are specifically using a type of limiter circuitry which will only going to pass our fixed amplitude carrier waveform and clip it off all other portion, this portion and this portion of my signal which has been produced due to the effect of noise. So obviously, amplitude variation above this particular level will going to be completely clip it off, and below this particular portion, whatever amplitude we're going to have is, it will clip it off. So we're going to only allow this amount of signals which lies in the variation of plus V volt to minus V volt. I'm sorry, it has to be plus V volt and it has to be minus V volt. So FM signal have a constant modulated carrier amplitude. FM receivers contains a limiter circuitry that deliberately restrict the amplitude of our received signal. So obviously, any amplitude variation occurring on the FM signal are effectively clipped by the limiter circuits. So this amplitude clipping does not affect the information content of the FM signal, since the FM signal's information is solely being contained in the frequency variation of my carrier waveform. So as long as we are in a state to preserve the frequency variation of my FM signal intact, then till that instant we'll not going to get our information signal distorted. or we'll going to clearly get the exact message signal. So now we're going to discuss about preemphasis and deemphasis in the FM system. The power spectral density, which has been given as S naught of F, which is basically the function of frequency of noise at the FM receiver output, has the square law dependence on the operating. This is actually a close observation of our high frequency noise. Hopefully you all know about the power spectral density as you had already studied in your signals and system subjects. But still, if you haven't, remember right now, on brief, I just wanted to say that power spectral density is nothing but it is the distribution of signal power over the frequency ranges in which signal has been defined. It is also being defined as the ratio of signal power to the range of frequencies over which the signal has been defined. So the high frequency noise is dominant at the output of an FM receiver. Why we are saying this? We are saying this just because FM band, which ranges between 88 MHz to 108 MHz at those frequency ranges, will be having a greater impact of high frequency noise. So this particular figure shows the power spectral density of my high frequency noise. So this particular figure shows that our high frequency noise is having a square law dependence over the operating frequency ranges. As our operating frequency is keep on increasing, the effect of noise is also being increasing. And that relationship between the operating frequency and the power of the noise is having the square law. On the other hand, if we closely observe our message signal, then the power spectral density of my message signal is having just opposite relationship as compared to our message signal. That means at lower value of frequencies, our message signal will going to have higher strength or higher power level. And as we move on or as the frequency goes on, the signal strength will get reduced. So this particular figure shows the power spectral density of my message signal. So the power spectral density of message signal usually falls off at the higher frequencies, as we have discussed in the last figure. Generally, the most part of the message signal is in the lower frequency regions. As in the last figure, we have seen that at lower value of frequencies, we'll be having the peak amplitude values of my message signal or peak power of my message signal. So these two facts can be exploited in order to improve the noise performance of the FM system. So what we're going to do in preemphasis and deemphasis in the FM system is, suppose we'll be having an FM transmitter, and here is the channel which is the main source of noise where we'll getting additive white Gaussian noise, and at the FM receiver we are trying to demodulate or receive our FM signal. So what we actually going to do is we'll going to use a filter at the transmitting side, which has been called as your preemphasis filter, and a filter at the receiving side, which actually performs the inverse operation of our preemphasis filter. So here HPE of F is the transfer function of our preemphasis filter. So initially we're going to apply message signal MT, which will going to pass through a preemphasis filter. So what our preemphasis filter will gonna do is it will going to increase the signal strength of our high frequency component of my message signal, and then we'll going to pass through the FM transmitter. So when the noise will going to affect our message signal, as we had already increased the strength of high frequency component, so when this high frequency noise will going to add it up to our message signal, it will not going to affect more as comparison to if we do not use any preemphasis filter. So obviously we'll going to receive out our FM signal, and then in order to nullify the effect of our preemphasis filter, we'll be using a deemphasis filter, which has been represented as HDE of F. It is the transfer function of our deemphasis filter. And then at the receiving side, we're going to get the message signal. So the basic idea of preemphasis and deemphasis in the FM system is we're going to apply a filter at the demodulator output, which reduces the high frequency component of the output spectrum. So as at the receiving side, we'll be using a filter which will going to reduce out the high frequency component of the output spectrum. Then in order to compensate this attenuation, a preemphasis must be applied to the high frequency signal at the transmitter. So now we're going to discuss at preemphasis at the transmitter. So in the whole complete scenario of preemphasis and deemphasis in the FM systems, we'll basically going to use two filters at the transmitting side. We'll be using a preemphasis filter whose job or responsibility is to enhance or increase the strength of high frequency component of my message signal. When they will get interaction with high frequency noise signal, the effect of noise could get minimized. And at the receiving side, when we're going to receive that signal, anyhow, we must have to reduce out those high frequency component such that we have changed them at the transmitting side so that we could get the exact modulated signal. So a filter that artificially emphasizes the high frequency component of the message signal prior to the modulation. It is all about using a preemphasis filter at the transmitter. So this particular equation shows the transfer function of our preemphasis filter. HPRE is equal to 1 plus J times of F over F0. So obviously noise can interfere with an FM signal and particularly with the high frequency components of the modulating signal. As in high frequency noise, we'll be having more noisy component at higher frequency levels. So noise is primarily sharp spikes of energy that contains a lot of harmonics and other high frequency components, as we had already discussed in our previous slide. So to overcome this high frequency noise, a technique that is known as preemphasis is being used. So a simple high pass filter can serve as the transmitter's preemphasis circuit. So this particular figure shows the preemphasis circuit at the transmitting side, which is nothing but basically a high pass filter which will going to pass all high frequency component with a high gain. So this particular high pass filter could serve as the preemphasis circuit at the transmitting side. So preemphasis provides more amplification of only high frequency components. So it will only going to give high amplification to the high frequency component. So now what do we mean by deemphasis at the receiver? Obviously, as we have changed our message signal at the transmitting side, then at the receiving side, we must have to perform the inverse operation, else we will going to get the changed information. So anyhow, we must have to change our information at the receiving side just inwardly as we have changed our information signal at the transmitting side. So an inverse operation is performed by the filter placed after the demodulation. So the deemphasis filter basically restores the original signal by deemphasizing the high frequency component, as we actually emphasizes the high frequency component at the transmitting side. So our deemphasizing circuit has to perform the inverse operation of our preemphasis circuit. So the transfer function of our deemphasis filter is being given as 1 over 1 plus J times of F over F naught. So the effect of preemphasis and deemphasis filter must have to cancel each other. So as this particular equation shows, the product of preemphasis and deemphasis turns out to be unity. So a simple low pass filter can operate as a deemphasis circuit in the receiver. So this particular figure shows a simple low pass filter which could behave as a deemphasis circuit in our FM system. Simple RC low pass filter is behaving or acting like a deemphasis circuit in our FM system. So deemphasis circuit returns the frequency response to its normal flat level. It basically performs the inward operation in contrast with our preemphasis circuit. So the combined effect of preemphasis and deemphasis is to increase the signal to noise ratio for the high frequency component during the transmission so that they will be stronger and not masked by the noise. So this particular paragraph shows the complete reasoning behind the use of preemphasis and deemphasis in the FM system. So as we all know that high SNR or high signal to noise ratio requirement at the receiving side is always desirable so that we could receive out the appropriate signal. We observed that high frequency noise mainly occurs at the FM band, or they actually occurs in the vicinity of hundreds of megahertz. So obviously the effect of high frequency noise over the FM band is much higher. So when we're going to transmit our FM signal without the use of preemphasis and deemphasis, the noise will get added up in our FM signal. So what it will going to do is it will simply going to distort our signal. So as that high frequency component of my message signal is usually having lower amplitude level, and when noise signal will going to added up, then the signal to noise ratio will become poorer. So in order to improve that signal to noise ratio, what we could do is anyhow we must have to increase the strength of my message signal. So with the help of preemphasis filters, we are actually trying to do that. As we are increasing the strength of my message signal at high frequency values, so the signal strength basically boosted up at high frequency values. So when the noise will going to add it up, it will not going to severely deteriorate the signal to noise ratio, as the signal power actually being boosted up. So with the help of preemphasis, we actually going to receive out a high SNR valued signal at the receiving side. So these are the major applications of AM and FM. Here on the left side we'll be having application, and over the right hand side we'll be showing what type of modulation techniques we are actually being using. So for AM broadcast radio, we'll be using AM. For FM broadcast radio, we'll be using FM. For FM stereo multiplex sound, we'll be using DSB and FM signal. For the sound of our TV, we'll be using, and for picture, we'll be using VSB modulation, which is your vestigial sideband. And for TV colored signals, we'll be using quadrature DSB. For cellular telephone, we'll be using FM, FSK and PSK. Basically it is in our first generation systems. In our second generation, third generation systems, we are basically using GMSK, Gaussian minimum shift keying, for transmitting our message signal. Then for cordless telephony, we'll be using FM and PSK. For fax machine, we'll be using QAM, which is nothing but your quadrature amplitude modulation, which is the combination of amplitude modulation and phase shift modulation. Then for aircraft radio, we'll be using AM signals. For marine radio, we'll be using FM and SSB, and so on. For our family radio service, we'll be using FM, and for our Bluetooth radio, we'll be using our frequency shift key. These are the various references. Thank you very much for your patient hearing.